10 days in French, in France, which means that she should be touring TV shows and the media and movie theaters in France, and she's with us tonight. So again, it's really a pleasure to have you. Thank you for traveling.
Another planet, and so it's like they just arrived two hours ago.
Oh my
God. Yeah, it's about from Paris.
Yeah, is there any
hope all my vocabulary will come back?
So I'll start with a question to Julie, and
first I want to thank you because you organized all this really incredible.
So I'm going to ask you sort of like the traditional first question that I keep asking to the filmmakers, but I think it's really important because again, life and cinema intertwined. I would like you to explain us how you worked on this film, that is to say, how you had access to this classroom and what was the daily life in this classroom and how you worked. Did you make the director of photography or not? And how long, for how long did you shoot? What was it? What happened? How was it?
So I spent 1 year with all these kids. Quite from the beginning of the year, just the first months, I just was to discover them, to ask them if they're okay, to show them my films, to discuss with them, just to be involved also with the class, with the teacher. And after I started shooting all the class year, around three times a week, sometimes not, it depends of what happened. I was talking a lot with the teacher between the lesson to know what will be the next theme or what will be what happens or if they have the appointment with the parents, what's happened with the all the school life, and because I was I'm not writing a script, I'm not in fiction, but I know that I have some point that I don't have to forget and to follow what happened with all the stories. So also I was hearing what happened with all these kids to know if maybe there is a problem now, I have to come back tomorrow because it would be interesting, they want to see the teacher, so I have to be there. So, it was not, it was depending of what happened, but I really want to come more often as possible. So, and I was alone, but I was on the camera, and I had a sound
engineer. The boom, yeah.
And so it was very easy because I have no light. I just sometimes take off the light of the neon lights of the school, the class sometimes. I was with a rolling chair, a rolling chair of an office. I stay in the corner of the class and just to move very quickly to have the kids between them, and the booner was maybe more inside the class sometimes. But I was on an area like that, and so they don't forget me for sure. It was really a film as all the documentary I make. I'm with the people, you know. I have the camera, but sometimes I put my camera on part and I'm talking with them, or I'm not. Transparent. I'm just here. You can't forget the camera, and even not more the boom and the microphone is coming up the head. So it was very moving because I spend also time with them when they go out for theater or something. I was there when there was not enough parents to go with them. I was involved with the class, and but I was not making nothing special for them. I never asked for something. It was really a mistake. Yeah, it's a good documentary, but I was very, a part of the class. I don't know how to say. I was not a school, not a teacher, not a not a student, but I was with them and they accepted from the beginning. And sometimes when I was not there, I meet them, so they want to ask, so when she's coming back, and when they saw me from the window that I'm here, they were really happy to see me. And so.
And you first, did you choose the school, a class, or a teacher?
In fact, the year before, I discovered that this adaptation class by chance, because I was asking to be director of a jury of a festival of school film, and this teacher came with her class from the year last year, and I discovered this sort of adaptation class. I did not know about it. And I completely fall in love with the 15 kids come from all over the world, talking about them, showing a very good film they did. And so, and this gives me the idea that so, oh, next year I really want to spend one year with all the world in a room like that, and how it is for them to live together. And so, when the next year started, I decided to first go to see this teacher, and the school was not far from my house, you know, 10 minutes by bike, so it was really great. But so I decided to go to see a lot of class to be sure that maybe another teacher would be better, or I don't know, a class. Or. But when I came there, so it was this class, and I saw all these girls, these guys. There was 22 different countries. It was not so often that it was really incredible even for this teacher. I was feeling that this teacher was really great, but you know, I experimented through some classes and I decided to stay there because I knew it would be everywhere very good, everywhere it would be all the stories, all the very good teacher too, but now I know them. I feel there is really good characters. It's not far from my house, so okay. So let's go, and I don't want to wait also 1 year because I thought before I have to write a script, you know, to find the money. So I have just to make
location
scouting. And so after the next year in September, I will start from the beginning. And in fact, I decided to go now because I didn't know that this teacher will. She didn't know either that she will leave the school at the end. But so I said it was a good character. But after I wrote the some page to find money, but we didn't find money anyway. So all the year I was writing, and so nobody wants the film. And so just at the end, when my producer. Okay, it was trusting me, and so she decided that we have to make the editing. And after the end of the editing, we find the money, we find the distributor for cinema, and even the TV, who during the year didn't want the film, they said, okay, in fact, you were right, it was a good idea, and good characters. So. But it was a bit difficult during the shooting, because I was alone. Each month we were waiting for somebody, some money somewhere, and nothing happened. So I was, and sometimes also during the shooting, it's a documentary that always funny, yeah? Because there is great days where you're really happy, there is a wonderful moment, and also a lot of days and nothing happens. It's a bit boring. You say, "Wow, staying 1 year in the class, even during 1 hour and a half, is it really possible?" So sometimes you don't trust yourself, and so
it's something that is really difficult to understand or even imagine. Is that France has a very very good, well functioning film industry, but still you can have films selected in Cannes and that garnered dozens of awards, and then you don't get any funding for the next film. It's very it's not non-linear. But I should actually not only pass the microphone to Emmanuelle Saada, but also introduce her. So I introduced your work and your research fields to Julie during the screening, but I didn't do it for the audience. So, and I should have. So yes, yes. But actually, your research is really about themes that are definitely at stake in the film. And so, Emmanuelle Saada is an associate professor here at Columbia and director of the Center for French and Francophone Studies. And your last book that has been translated here and published in the United States in 2012 is entitled "Empire's Children: Race, Filiation, and Citizenship in the French Colonies." And you work actually on also, well, I read, and we can talk about that, that you're working on a historiographical book reflecting on French and European colonization as a history of the present, which is definitely something really interesting for our discussion tonight. That's it. We kept it. I have one question about Julie has very much highlighted that she wanted to talk about language in the film, through this film. And I would like maybe to have more explanations, highlights about how the access to the capability to speak French is something that is important or not in the access to citizenship in France, historically, maybe now.
Sure. So that I can thank you for a wonderful book. That's true that it's, as you said in your introduction, it's it does provide a rather more positive and joyful note to the issue of immigration to France today. Okay, so language, yes, obviously language had, I mean, there's a very long history of the importance of language in France in terms of, I mean, as one of the very important element of national identity, actually comes from, you know, maybe the 18th century. So at the moment of the revolution, there are already all these projects of, you know, teaching French lessons, how to speak French in order to be good citizens, with a very strong, I mean, a very an emphasis on these policies at the end of the 19th century, with, you know, the expansion of French schooling, of elementary schooling, and the widespread of, you know, of French. So what is interesting is that obviously immigrants who came to France in the beginning of the, in the middle of the 19th century have also been exposed to that. So in, you know, a huge part of the immigrant experience in France for, you know, the past 150 years has been to learn French, often through kids. So that was, you know, very typical what you were showing, that those kids were, you know, learning French and then helping their parents with papers, with interactions with the administration. That's an experience that all of, you know, immigrants have had throughout history. And just to speak about citizenship, in a way, the French proficiency is like, you know, the maybe one of the most important criteria for citizenship at the, in France, when you want to become a French citizen, when you want to get naturalization, when you want to be naturalized, you have to take an exam in which your French is being judged. So there's a French language exam, so it's an oral exam of French, and you have to speak French actually very interestingly according to your social status. So it's your social location. So depending on, you know, your level of education in your previous country, depending on your profession, you have to have a different level of French, which I think tells a lot about also the class dimension of French. But one of the things I like to notice in this movie that I found very different, I was wondering if it was because it's a teacher, the teacher was doing something specific, or is this a, well, I was wondering if there was a change in the French pedagogy, and the, you know, the learning of French to immigrants, is that, as, I mean, like, the title was very revealing too, of the cour de Babel, that there was a very strong presence of foreign languages. So at the beginning, all these, you know, those students are encouraged to teach, you know, the greetings in their native languages. You even have the use of translators. We have the two Chinese kids with the one translating for the other, the two Korean kids. And so this is rather different. So this kind of, you know, value put on their native languages, on their culture, the kind of smooth transition from one language to the other, that is very different from the classical kind of, you know, big pedagogy of I mean, the idea we have of the legality of French as a second language was much a little more, let's say, obligious of former language. So is it something that was specific to this teacher, or is it something that is being done now in this class, the adaptation?
I think it depends of the teacher. It's true that this teacher is especially open to this sort of pedagogy, but it's not just her. I think it's a moving, it's on the way, because it's really special on this adaptation class. It's not as how it is in the normal class when you learn language. It's terrible how you learn language. Is foreign language in French. It's I don't know how it's possible. I think we have difficulty in French because our language has no music language. So it's maybe hard for us to learn foreign language, but also the teachers, I don't know, they're never English, never Italian, not so often, and there's less hours, I don't know, it's terrible. But in this sort of class, I think that it's other teachers who are really very involved. You know, it's a political choice to be in this sort of class. And it's the program is more open, it's more free, I think, so they really do what they want, they pick a different open pedagogy also, you know, the Freinet or the Montessori, and all these pedagogy, they can use it if they want, and this teacher also writes a book about pedagogy, how to learn French like a second language. So for her it was really important that they don't forget their language, and I also, because they have to, you know, she asked them to talk about a lot of things. And it's for two reasons. First, because if you want to learn, if you want to speak another language, you have to want, you have to have the really, to want to speak about something that interests you. So if they ask them to talk about their life, their problems, they really want to. If you have just to talk about two kids in the market or all the books, it's boring for them, and they're so moved by what they live so that they really want to talk, and also all what they talk about is how it's difficult for them, all the problems they find. It's the way for the class to be a group, to find that all together they have the same problem, and they can recognize them in a, like brother and sister that the girls say at the end. So it's not just to talk about for fun, it's just because at the beginning of the year they find they're just alone, different, they're shy, and they difference it here, and step by step they discover that no, everybody is like this, the same problem, the same situation. And so it put them all together, and they are stronger, and after they can fight against all the, you know, the sarcasm, the people who are not so nice with them, and also, so they're less and less shy, and so all these two things is a very good pedagogy, and I don't think all the teachers are like that. That's why really I chose this one, because she was especially clever about how you can make a group, how you can be stronger, and how it's good not to forget your roots and so and your language.
I have one question about the parents. You almost respected sort of you did your unit A, and you didn't really put outside the classroom except in the swimming pool and the film festival. And you've explained why you didn't want to make portraits of the students. But I think that the portraits or their stories come from the outside with the parents, through the parents, who become really characters, I don't know, but they are really important in your film. I was very moved, I mean, these are among the scenes that really moved me most. I was wondering how you built that, and how you also managed to, how to keep the proportions, you know, between every story, every character. It's that film in these terms, not only that it's really successful because you have more than 100 of hours of footage, and it's really dense, it's very efficient in a very good way. You know, it's a short film in the end, so I was wondering how you trust the characters apparently.
Right. It's true that it was not easy to do editing part, especially because from the beginning I didn't want to choose some kids, you know, just five or six more important or more spectacular children. I really want to have the group, and I knew by experience that some kids at the beginning they are very shy, maybe they are not really important like this. They look like, and step by step during the year they can be like flowers, you know, like this little Chinese who really at the end it's so moving. And it was my first day of shooting when she arrived in the class, and everybody say hello in all language, and during maybe 2 months she never opened her mouth, and so I was really sad because it was one Chinese and it's very important Chinese immigration in France, so say oh, but I always shooting her, and so and I knew that it's step by step it will be changing, and because it's also teenager, it's the really moment where they constricting, they're building their identity, they are changing, they are looking for themselves, they are between two worlds, between two age, and it's a moment really important. So I had to be open to all this changing moment, and but also I wanted to have the group, and it's true that it was not easy for me because I really don't want to go to their home. I wanted to stay in this little cocoon, I don't know what you can say, because the class is like, you know, the nest for them, and they need to be stronger all together just to fly in this strong and difficult life. So because at home, yes, it will be easy to see how they are poor, how small, and so on, but I prefer to hear it or to feel it between the line, you know, when the parents are there, how are their teeth, how they are smiling, how they are shy to talk about something, how the kids saying, oh yes, it's a bit small, at home it's difficult for me to make homework. I prefer to hear that than to show it, because I think also I have to respect their intimacy, and so it was a... For me, I feel better. In documentary, it's always hard to what the line to cross, because we never know what the image can do. You know, so it was the way I built the film, and I was, as I said, a bit anxious sometimes. I said, if it's really possible, but I was trusting them because all the discussion, all this moment, also the progression of their French, about their way they talk about them was so wonderful that I was trusting that all the group is really the character and the teacher for sure, and the teacher, it was also the leading choice to discover more and more. You know, at the beginning we don't see her more, a lot, I mean, and step by step when really we need it, and because also she became a moving character, so we saw her, but the voice is like the vertebral column, and but
the first, spine.
Yeah, but it was first the children, my main characters, but I think that step by step it was useful also we want to discover her, so we are waiting for her, and so when she comes, it's more stronger.
One last question to Emmanuelle and Saada, and then I'll open the mic to the audience. In the class, there are more than 20 nationalities, and there are many different, very, very different migration journeys and origins. You know, some sons of diplomats, children of, you know, parents who are trying to find a job, children who sent to a relative, you know, not to get married too early in Senegal, in Africa, etc., etc. I was wondering if it's, and if it's representative of immigration today, what are the perspectives also historically?
Yeah. So obviously, the sociology of that group is pretty specific in the sense that they have all these nationalities that are not very highly represented among immigrant students, like Irish people or Ukrainians. I mean, they're very, very small numbers of those nationalities in France today, and they're actually not even immigrants, so people from Ireland don't count as, as a politically constituted figure of the immigrants. So that's one of the issues. I mean, obviously, maybe it has to do with the location, the Rue de la Grande Robert in the, the center of Paris, which is, I mean, you would not have the same kind of, population maybe in, 20 miles north of Paris. It would be a different kind of, and actually, they don't even know if they have those classes everywhere, and they do. When I was, so I was born in the, in the suburbs of Paris, 20 miles north of Paris, and when I was in school, they had programs for actually Arab kids, and they were taking them out of the classroom in order to teach them Arabic. That was, that was in elementary school, late 70s, early 80s, when the idea was to send them back to North Africa. So the whole different kind of, relationship to languages. So, but I mean, I think things have changed, but what I'm saying here is that, in a way, what the movie does is to insist on the migration itself, on the journey, as you said, on the fact that they have all these kids who find themselves in that classroom, coming from very, very different backgrounds, obviously, and have different kind of experiences. So that's the beauty of the movie, in many ways, is that it's emphasizing the foreignness, the distance from the French language, the apprenticeship. But it's true that it's not insisting on, it seems to me, on immigration as a political program, in the sense that it's not, those are not for many, of those kids here, now some of them are, obviously, but those are not the immigrants that are constituted as, that's one of the other things that I found very interesting, was the difference between those kids, what their families with them. Where were these families, and all these kids who were estranged from their families, all these girls who either had not seen their mothers for 10 years, as Dean had, or also who was not with her mom, and was basically, going from one household to the other, her cousin, her aunt, and friend of her cousin, and so on and so forth. So, that I think is something that is worth maybe underlining in terms of the transformation of the condition of immigrant to France. There are more and more young people who try, as you know from the issues of refugees, people in Lausanne right now, all these actually minor students, people who are under the age of 18 who are without their families, who are, so this is, I think, and it's not completely new, there are patterns obviously of youth immigration, but right now we are very high level of that, and that, I think that was something that was very important, because you could see in terms of the behavior of the kids and the emotion, they all need old school, so they're very strong emotions. It was beautiful, like this kind of emotional stories on the 13 and 14 years old. It was beautiful, but you could see the, seems to me that that was a, I don't know if that's something that was particularly interesting to you, but that's something that struck me, the presence, absence of the mother, especially.
No, it's true that I think it's a really real phase of the immigration in France, even maybe the more Arabic or more East sometimes, but in fact it was the real class and it was like this. But I think there is no one immigration, it's all the faces, all the story, it's love story or political problems or worse things, and everything is right, and sometimes in France we the political problems are pointing just the war problem or the economic problem, but in fact there is a lot of, most are mixed from, so it's the way the bad political show that the problem of immigration is just this one, but in fact there is no one immigration. So I was very happy that it was so diverse like that in this class. And there is a lot of kids who have no paper, so I put them to have paper at the end of the film. Really, it was not so easy stories and for a lot. But it's true that the Irish guy, so it's European and quite, so it was so difficult for them to have the paper. But it's another problem to be foreign. Even if you have the paper, there's problems. So.
There's a microphone that you could take, ask questions to Julie.
You were talking about hope at the beginning and what maybe said about hope, but I think it's more optimistic about human being and group than about friends and how it's integrated, because people are saying in the film that it's hard to live in Paris and friends and they're not so happy. So what did you think about that aspect? Maybe it was not made on purpose, so were you surprised about that?
No, you're right, it's bad. I'm hoping about the human being. But also, the thing also is when there is problem of immigration, for me, the problem of how they are received. If the accueil, the welcome way, quand l'accueil est réussi, oui, quand on accueille bien les gens, l'intégration se passe bien. When you receive well the people, the integration has no problem, you know, and we feel that in this class, this woman is so open and they help so much and they put them confidence and they it will be a success. The integration will be a success. When you're afraid, when you don't help the people, for sure it's difficult and immigration can be dramatic. And it was, I think, the feeling I had when I saw them and what the message maybe I want to give. But also, it's not the immigration like, you know, in France there are also big areas where there is the old immigration from two or three generations, especially Arabic, for example, or black people. It's true that it's difficult because it's 20 years of relegation, of all in the area, they are all together, poor, without job, and so the schools are terrible, nobody's hearing at school, so okay. But this is the new people have just arrived, so they are full of hope, they really want to succeed in school, and it has to be like this in each, must be like this normally in each class, even for the little kids, because at the beginning you want to succeed, you want to be integrated, and step by step, because the school doesn't know how to help them, it's beginning the nightmare. But if everybody would be like her, it would be great everywhere, because you know it depends on if you trust them, if you tell them, yeah, you can be a doctor for sure. Parents are not doctors, but it's possible. And France was, the school in France was really the very successful of the social mobility. And now, step by step, it's disappeared because, you know, there's ghettos everywhere, and Paris is no more a mixed city, so it's very so sad.
Yeah. But that specific place in Paris might be. I mean, that neighborhood of you know, where film is you know,
not so much.
It's in the 10. Yes, it's quite canal. It's quite poor area. One of the last, because all Paris now is really very expensive. But it's one of the poor areas, and also the kids from there are not always from. They can come also from suburb, right? Because the one with the free place, and, but there is a lot of classes, you know, in all France and all in Paris, and maybe 400 and for everywhere.
It's a neighborhood that has been extremely and very rapidly gentrified. Mm-hmm. So I need to underline that.
First of all, congratulations, and I really hope your movie is going to be shown in schools also in France, because I think your movie brought us that question of how those people are, you know, shown and integrated also in the schooling system. I was also wondering if your camera, the presence of your camera, brought some kind of question around the representation of those kids in our screens in France, and if it became some kind of self-reflexive. I mean, to remain politically correct, we have to improve our representation of youth and colored or migrant youth in France. And if they watch television, this medium is somehow coming up all the time for them. So I don't know if your camera brought those questions and those debates.
I hope so. It's true that the film had a quite great success when it's screening out in cinema. It's made a lot of entries and a lot of very good reviews, and so. So people talk a lot, and they said, "Wow, it's a way to look in another way our immigrant." And so I think it's helped, and also it helped in the education way, because systemically all the Ministry of Education saw the film. They said, "Wow, well, it's true. That's a great thing we have." So because I said, "Okay, it's great to I think it's better sometimes to make a film about what's succeed, what is good, because like this you protect them, and also you said, you know, it's possible to do good, great thing, because if you just show what is bad, everybody's crying and nobody's nothing happens, because it's true that the world is terrible, and so, but if you show people who do things great, I think it's helping everybody. So in this sort of, the film had a help some way, and also it was shown in a lot of school and a lot of not a lot everywhere in France, and so it was helping. I hope the class to understand themselves, the kids also to see in another way the foreign, and the film start continue to be shown in the school now and in the cine club, and also it's go on, and so I hope, but. The thing is, when it was in the cinema, you're always afraid that who came, the people who are already, you know, touched by the story, and so I'm not sure the people really, the big racism will come to see the film. But when you show that in the class, and when it's, you know, in the program of the class, you know that it's a little bit, maybe these kids will not come with their parents because their parents don't think like that. So it's really useful and more useful for me that. But it was great to be in cinema and also in TV, because 2 years after Arte shown it also at the TV and again. But I think the more important is at school, because it's again, you know, the seed, seeds in the for new trees.
Have you kept in touch with those kids?
Yes.
I had a question about the format, the like there is some almost like a Truffautian, François Truffautian influence, like, you know, the culture, most with the music, with the, you know, the shock of the culture, like on the repeated intervals, there are people with François Truffaut more than I do here, but I was interested, is that like, where were you trying to do, like, in some way, like a French classical film about childhood, and but like, you know, including this with a different, you know, kind of life,
in a different language? In fact, I forget all my reference, you know,
yes.
You say Truffaut, I forget that Truffaut, I knew Truffaut films, but I was not trying to make as Truffaut, or I always, when you make a film, you have to try to forget, because it's too difficult, because all the masterpieces were already done about all the subjects. But it's true that I think it's intention, and it's also the way I did all my film before, so
sometimes this sort of sensibility, I don't know, I'm not looking for that, it's very instinctive. But it's true that in France there is a lot of film about school. It's really a documentary, fiction, it's a long, long story. And it's always for us, always, you know, the Republican school, it's something very strong because it's wonderful to have this no religion school, everything is possible. It's great to have this Republican school, and it's very, we want her to stay like that, and we know it's difficult because she has no more money, she's very concurrenced by the private school, and the political people really don't care really about it. They said they care, but in fact, it's hopeful how there is no more money, no more really big projects. So, I think we want to make a film about school because it's the way of all the possibility of to have a big country. And you want to know if I'm always in touch with them and they are really in a good way. Every kids are go on with their studies. Some came back to their country like the Irish guy, Lucas, with her mother, and also Jenna Boo, she go back to see her parents. Right? Were diplomatic in Arabian subjects. So now she's with the big things and you know the world. Yeah. But she's in a good school and keep in touch with Facebook and so on. So no, but they are all continue. Even no, just the one just this year. I'm really sad because Xin, the Chinese girl, just decided to stop. Study because her mother had a problem with her. She was ill, and so she had to do and to work for a job in a restaurant, and she was happy to make this job in a restaurant, and she didn't really want to have a better level to maybe to own the restaurant, not to be just a waitress. So, but for the moment, you know, she's young and. I know that she is strong inside, and maybe after a few years she will be stronger than her mother for that. No, but really they are incredible. These guys, all these kids, they are all together also in touch. Mm-hmm. And the film was a big story for them, sure, because it's they had a lot of interviews and things and moment together. So it's really moving to see them often.
Mm-hmm. One more question, one last question.
Yeah. Hi, thank you for the movie. I see myself up there because I'm a success mentor involved with the community school, which runs side by side with the DOE, Department of Education. And so our role becomes like the league. They come in, they cry because their parents are here, either in Guinea or Togo, and we have to. I would love for the teachers, the faculty, to see this. We are in 150 schools. Hmm. Right now, we're mostly in the South Bronx. So what I'm referring to are actually schools in the South Bronx, or in Brooklyn, or in Harlem. The population is not quite well how to deal with this young students. And so this would be a great opportunity for them to see themselves and see how they can be of help to these kids. Hmm.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I think we'll need to wrap up now. Julie has time. She traveled all the way from Paris. Maybe there's a very, very last question, or can we, you know, we can continue. Okay, one last question. You're staying, so you know.
I'm just curious about what happened to the refugees. Some of the children are refugees, and my extension to this question is, refugee status, does it make immigrants different? As well as an answer to that question.
But no, but I say, in the film, the especially two kids who are refugees succeed to have the asylum.
was a, but in another different way, because one was helped because in fact he could not have the refugees, but they find another way to accept them, and Myriam, they succeed, and it was a problem also of family problems, also the country, but especially because of her mother was going out of the country because of her husband who bites her, and so she get away with his five kids alone, and so she was really protected. So I was very happy because it was not during the film, but 1 year after. She was in Verdun, the little town, really not so nice. There was no adaptation class in this, because it's true there is a lot, but not everywhere, and so it was hard for them. And after 2 years, she came back to Paris, and so now it's really better, and they have all what they need for flat, for a little help, social security, and so on. So it's a nice story. And it's true that there's not always a nice story. It's a lot of problems. It's very long to have the asylum. But often, when it's a real story like that, and for good reason, I think it succeeds. It still works. Really. But we have to fight. I help them to find a good lawyers. It's a fight. For everything is important. Even that I give my letter to help them. And everything is when you're alone, when you have no money, because you know nobody, it's hard to have a dinner because everybody wants to push them out for sure. But still, there is a lot of association with them. There is a good, big tradition in France to help immigration.
Thank you very much.
I'm still here. So yeah.